Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Yesterday, our Tahoe was giving us a P0521 engine code, which relates to the engine oil pressure sensor. I went ahead and fixed that issue, and as we can see with our code reader right here, we have no more codes stored in the vehicle. So we went ahead and fixed the issue with the oil pressure sensor. So today I'm gonna go ahead and talk to you about signs and symptoms of a P0520 to 524 engine codes, as well as the diagnostic steps that you can take to fix it. The oil pressure sensor reads the oil pressure levels within the engine. When you have an issue with a sensor, you're going to get a P0520 through P0523 engine code that lets you know that there is an issue specifically with the sensor. Now, you can also get a P0524 engine code, which is actually going to indicate that you have low engine oil pressure. However, the P0520 to 523 just indicates that you have an issue with the sensor. So the sensor, when it goes bad or goes faulty, what it can do is send a consistent oil pressure reading to the vehicle's computer, and that will let the vehicle's computer know that there's an issue with the sensor because the oil pressure should go up and down depending on whether you're idling or whether you're driving. So if it sends a constant reading, it's going to trigger a P0520 engine code to let you know that you've got some type of issue with the sensor on the car. This can be a very serious engine problem if you do have low engine oil pressure. What happens if you have low oil pressure is you're not adequately lubricating all of the internal components of the engine, which can cause significant internal engine damage. And so this is not an engine code to take lightly. I will say the majority of the time it happens to be a very simple fix, but if you get the associated P0524 engine code, sometimes even if you don't get it, it can mean that you have engine oil pressure issues, which could lead to serious engine damage if you don't address it. And so if you have this engine code, I'd recommend following these diagnostic steps and working through it and fixing it before you do too much driving, because it can cause some serious issues. So there are a couple different things that can cause this. The first one, and the most common one, which is the issue with this car, is just having low engine oil. If you don't have enough engine oil in your vehicle, that will trigger issues with your oil pressure, which will send the sensor off and give you one of these engine codes. So the majority of the time, the simple thing is just to add more oil in there. One other way to know that you're having this issue is to read your dashboard. If your dashboard says that you have low oil, then you need to go ahead and put some more oil in it. So that's the most likely cause, and the first thing to check is what your oil levels are, and if they're too low, go ahead and top them up. The second problem that we can have is a problem with the oil pressure sensor itself and the oil pressure sensor going faulty. And then the third thing is if we have more serious problems, and we're going to go ahead and break this category into low oil pressure issues. And so we'll go ahead and talk about a couple of things that can cause low oil pressure. But let's go ahead and open the trunk here and take a look at this engine. I'm going to show you guys a couple things. So if we look at this engine here in our Tahoe, one of the things that you'll notice if you look closely over here around the valve cover and the exhaust manifold are completely black. So we do have a pretty decently sized oil leak coming from the valve cover. That's the reason that we're running into P0521 engine codes on this, is we're leaking oil. Eventually the oil gets a little bit too low, and then that sets off the check engine light for the P0521. And so that's the issue on this vehicle here. I need to get our valve covers fixed. The oil pressure sensor, which is going to be the second most common cause of issues with these engine codes, is located on the very back of the block, and so it's a little bit difficult to get to on this engine, but I know that's not the issue because putting more oil in it fixes the code. But the second thing to do is to check your actual oil pressure sensor. It's going to be in a different location on different vehicles, but sometimes it can get dirty or gunked up as well. You can pull that, try cleaning it, pop it back in, and see if that fixes it. Now, the third category, which is the more serious problems, is if you actually have low engine oil pressure. There's a couple things that can cause that. The first being a bad oil pump. The oil pump is what actually moves all of the oil around in the engine and creates oil pressure. So if the oil pump fails, you'll have low oil pressure, and you'll need a new oil pump. The second thing is you have an oil drain pan or an oil catch pan at the bottom of these vehicles. That's where all the oil is stored. And then there is a tube that sucks the oil back up to basically circulate it throughout the engine. And so you can have a dirty or clogged up oil pickup tube. And what that will do is prevent oil from being picked back up and circulated through the system. It'll create a restriction, which will result in low engine oil pressure. To check that, you're gonna have to pull the oiled pan, which is a little bit more difficult of a task. Hopefully that's not the case, but that is another common cause that can cause low engine oil pressure. A third thing is gonna be with the oil pressure relief valve. There is a valve that bleeds off oil pressure if it gets too high or too low. If that is completely opened up, you could be bleeding off too much pressure, or if it's closed, you could be building up too much oil pressure, which could give you any one of these P0520 engine codes as well. And then some of the more serious things is you could have major oil leaks. You could have an issue with your head gasket or just have some very serious oil leaks throughout the engine. If you have too big of an oil leak, that can actually bleed off oil pressure as well as causing a lot of oil to leak out of it. The oil leak that we have on here isn't significant enough for it to be bleeding off enough oil pressure for it to cause this issue. It is a decent sized leak, but it is still minor in nature, but it is possible for oil leaks to get big enough for them to actually bleed off a lot of pressure and cause low engine oil pressure. So our three categories here is low engine oil, a bad oil pressure sensor, or actually having low oil pressure. So let's go ahead and talk about steps to diagnose and fix these problems. Like you saw in there, I figured out about this problem because of a code reader. We have a little bit more heavy duty of a code reader, but you can get a basic code reader for about $20, and that's gonna be the most helpful thing in pointing you in the right direction. You might not always just have a P0521 engine code. You might have another engine code that relates to a different part of the oiling system, which is causing you to have a P0521 code. And so it's always important to read your codes and see what other codes you might possibly have, since that can help you narrow down what the exact issue is. So always start with code reading and diagnostics to make sure you know what all engine codes you're getting. And then the first thing that I would recommend is putting more oil in your vehicle or checking your oil levels and making sure that there's enough in there. Another thing that could cause this too is having a dirty oil filter. And so if you haven't done an oil change recently, my second step would be to do an oil change, put a new oil filter in there and put fresh oil in there. Just because the oil filter can get clogged up, but also if your oil's really dirty, that can impact pressure as well. Doing a complete oil change is a good second step. If you're still getting issues with your P0520 to 523 engine code after putting more oil in it or doing an oil change, then I'd recommend replacing the oil pressure sensor. The sensors are pretty inexpensive, and on most vehicles, they're a little bit easier to replace than on this one, so I'd go ahead and recommend replacing the sensor at that point. If replacing the sensor, adding oil and doing an oil change and replacing the oil filter don't fix it, then you're gonna have to start looking into some other more serious problems, like issues with your oil pump or the oil pickup tube, or maybe you have head gasket issues or some very serious oil leaks to take care of. So that's kind of the order of diagnostics here. Start with your oil levels, make sure those are good, the oil filter. So starting with the easy and least expensive things to fix, and then we can move into some more advanced diagnostics if that doesn't fix it. But unless your engine's really going through hell, it's probably gonna be an issue with your oil filter, your oil levels, or just dirty oil. But anyways, guys, that's all I've got for P0520 to 524 engine codes. I hope this helped you fix the issues that you have going on with your car. If you have any questions or need help with diagnostics, go ahead and shoot a comment below and I'll do my best to get back to you. Thanks for watching this video. If you appreciate the content, please subscribe to the channel and click that like button.